My name is Xander, and this is Xander on Demand. Today, we're going to talk about the why, the when, and the where of the rideshare community and the delivery community. Okay, so basically an on-demand community where always looking for reasons to do things, and this is going to answer three of those questions for you. The what, the where, and the why. The first thing I want to talk about is the why. When you're thinking about doing something, the first question you ask yourself is, why are you doing it? There's always a reason why you do something. Okay? When you're working out there on demand, rideshare, delivery, whatever it is, the question you have to ask yourself is, why are you doing it? What is the purpose behind the outcome of this? Okay? Whether it's, you know, paying for your family's future, getting you through college, putting food on the table. Maybe it's a side gig for extra income. There's always got to be a reason why you're doing what you're doing. All right. And that's the biggest thing to find out is, why do you do what you do? Why do you drive? Do you drive for the flexibility, family reasons? Do you drive for extra side cash? That's the biggest question you have to ask yourself when you are going out there and ultimately coming back with some sort of an income from the rideshare industry. Always think about the why. Why are you doing it? Because if you think about why you're doing it, you're going to be better at it. Especially if that why has something to do with maybe your children, maybe it's your spouse. One of the things that I would encourage you to do is, if there is a child involved in this why, or there is a family venture involved in this why, put a picture of that in your car when you're out there driving, when you're out there taking people from point A to point B. And that way you can really show what it is that is causing you to do what you're doing. The next, number two, I'm going to talk about when. Okay. You need to know when you need to know when to drive so that you can maximize your earning potential. When to drive is very crucial. All right. What I use in determining this, Lyft has a really good feature that allows you to substantiate when throughout an entire week upcoming that you're going to make the most money. You're going to maximize your earning potential. There's more rides. It's a projection. Okay. It's a bar graph that's a projection in 30-minute increments. And it goes from 5 a.m. to 5 a.m., basically, 4:30 a.m. is the last half hour mark there. And the bar graph shows you low, medium, and high. And when the bars are up high, that means that the traffic, the business should be there. They're projecting that the business is going to be outrageous. All right, Uber does not do something like that, which is why you have to determine when you're going to drive, okay? When you're thinking about the when, you need to think about when people are going to need rides, if it's rideshare. If it's delivery, when are people going to need those deliveries? When are people going to be eating? That is what determines your when you're looking at actually making a plan to actually go out and work. The next thing I'm going to talk about is the where. Lyft has this feature, so does Uber. And what they do is, when business is in high demand, they highlight certain areas of the map. That shows you where the highest demand is in your area. When you're thinking about where the highest demand is in your area, maybe it's a boost or a surged area right now. And maybe it's a little bit of a distance. And that's where you're going to be ultimately deciding to work the majority of your day. When you are deciding the where throughout the day that you're going to drive, that is part of your plan, but you should be heading towards that direction when you first start out, when you first go online. There's a few tips in the where. One of those tips is using the destination filter. Uber and Lyft have a destination filter that allows you to determine where you're going. Let's say you're in the Chicago market, for instance, and you're trying to go out to O'Hare International Airport. And that seems to be where the demand is right around in that region. So wherever you live, your destination may be not necessarily the airport, but somewhere around the airport. And you set that destination, you want to head toward there, you're going to get all sorts of trips. Any trips that you get are going to go in that direction. Okay? So keep that in mind when you're using the destination filter. Now, you can have another destination filter later on when you're ready to go home. You can set a destination filter to your home address, or maybe it's something that you want to do on the way home. You can set your destination filter to there. When you're setting a destination filter, you're only going to get rides going in the direction of your destination. Now, not necessarily are they going to go all the way up to your destination. Maybe your destination is 20 miles away and you get 4 rides going 4 miles. That paid for 16 of that 20 miles getting to your destination, okay? You only get 2 of these a day on Uber or Lyft, so use them wisely. What I like to do is I like to decide where I'm going to drive, and I like to just head in that direction. Forget about the destination filter. I like to head in that direction. The only time I like to use destination filter is when I'm done for the day, and I don't want to receive any rides that are not going in the direction I'm heading, okay? So that's the only time I use destination filter. Part of the where, using a destination filter. So as long as you know why you're driving, when you're driving, and where you're driving, you have a really good plan set up to move in the right direction, all right? So again, remember why you're doing it. That's number one, remember why you're doing it. If you don't know why you're doing it, stop and think, why am I about to do this? What is in it in the end? Do I like it? Is there something in the future for me if I do this? Okay, find that why for yourself. The second thing to find is the when you're going to drive. Make sure you find out and plan when you're going to drive so you can maximize your earning potential. Sometimes when it's rideshare, the best times to drive are in the morning when people are on the way to work. And then the good thing is, in my market, when you start out at 4 or 4:30, 5 o'clock in the morning, you take a break about 7 or 8, maybe 9 o'clock when the business starts to die down a little bit. And then about 10 o'clock, people are starting to get ready for lunch, so you can do deliveries. Pick an area where you want to deliver, and you can do deliveries for a couple of hours until it busies back up with rideshare. If you are doing a 12-hour shift or even an 8-hour shift, it's best to schedule some 10 to 15 minute breaks in there for yourself so that you're not constantly beating yourself up when it comes to constant trips. Make sure you're spending some time outside the car, walking around a little bit, standing up. Make sure you're setting aside 10 to 15 minutes for yourself when you're doing a large shift all at once, okay? If you're doing that 12-hour shift, make sure you're setting aside some time in there to just relax. You know, maybe it's between 9 and 10, between rideshare and delivery, and then again between delivery and rideshare, okay? Whatever it may be, make sure you're setting aside time for yourself. Make sure you're setting a set schedule to where you know when you're done. And when you're done, don't keep milking the cow, so to speak. Stop. Set a destination filter to home, take those last minute trips, and be done. Well, regardless of whether it's busy or not, be done. Don't try to overwork yourself, okay? With that being said, that's the end of the video. I post Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, as well as a live feed on the Facebook page every Sunday afternoon. And there's also a Facebook group if you'd like to join it there. With that being said, you guys, thank you very much for watching. Again, smash that like button, subscribe, hit that notification bell if you haven't done so already. The notification icon is what helps you get notified when I post future videos. Until then, all the links are in the description below. See you in the next video.